Hello guys, assalamu alaikum. How are you guys? Sasikal, namaste, ni hao, swadika. So this video is all about how much money you're gonna make in Australia and how much money you can earn on student visa. This is the most asked question by me, by most of the people who message me, who follows me, who direct message me on my page, my Instagram, everywhere. Will they be able to achieve their tuition fees while working here on student visa? So we're gonna categorize in two streams. First one is the student visa, the other one is rest of the all the visas, because most of the people are coming here on student visa. So I'm gonna talk about more about student visa. So first thing, you got your visa anywhere from Pakistan, from India, Nepal, Bangladesh, China, Thailand, Japan, anywhere from this world, you come here in Australia on student visa. How much you make, how much you gonna earn in terms of your tuition fees and how many hours you are allowed. So first you come here on student visa. Student visa only allows you to work only for 20 hours, because you are writing for the immigration that you're gonna get the visa only in Australia just for the study purpose, not for a work purpose. But Australian governments are nice enough, kind enough to give you 20 hours to work to pay your bills. Okay, so what people are doing, I'm talking about generally mostly South Asian countries, which includes Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, maybe a little bit China or Nepal or whatsoever, who coming in student visa and start working here more than 20 hours or 20 hours or less than 20 hours. First thing first, I came here 5 years ago. 5 years ago when I arrived here in Australia, Melbourne, I was studying in Holmes Institute, which is on Spring Street. So Holmes Institute fees was 7,000, something like that. And nowadays it increased to 8,000 or 9,000. But because of so many students are already here in Australia, so government stopped giving visas on small institute and small colleges or something like that. The only visa you're gonna get, easiest way, is to get a university visa. Universities are giving you an offer letter, but it has more fees as compared to the institutes and colleges. Okay, first thing first, my fees was $7,000 5 years ago. Nowadays, in anywhere you're gonna come in Australia, most probably you're gonna come into La Trobe University, RMIT or Melbourne Uni, whatever, so which has a tuition fees of from 12,000 to 16,000 in between. Okay, roughly it's 14,000 for a semester. So for example, will you able to pay $14,000 once you arrived in Australia? Okay, the answer is no. Guys, first thing first, if you compare here, the pay rate is very high, but if you are working for 12-20 hours officially, you will not able to pay your fees by yourself. The first semester fees you are already paid, that's how you're gonna get the visa. But the second semester you won't be able to pay your fees until and unless you work more than 20 hours. So you're gonna breach the visa term, which I will not recommend you guys. So if you guys, I'll tell you how to make money. Okay, so how people make money is here. They show the 20 hours, they work it on the papers, they work on 20 hours. Okay, and which is, I think they work more than first they work on 20 hours, they go to the restaurant, they give their CVs, they go to different warehouses, they give their CV, any references, through the references they're gonna get the work. So 20 hours they show it on their TFN, which is tax file number, and then the rest of the hours they work here under the table, which I never recommend anyone doing something wrong here. So telling you the truth, how you gonna pay your fees. So don't expect yourself that you're gonna make $14,000 for a semester in the first year. It's impossible, guys. People who are coming here, they are asking me, will they be able to pay their whole fees? No, guys. If you're gonna work hard, even though you work hard, you work for two jobs, one is for 20 hours, other is under the table. A lot of Australian people working on cafes and restaurants getting $20 an hour and not paying taxes. So it's It's nothing wrong to talk about it. It's wrong to not to talk about it. So I'm telling you the truth. You can work here illegally, but you will still not be able to make $14,000 for a semester. Okay, guys. So be ready if you are coming in Australia. Don't you think that oh, you're gonna make money or you drive taxi or security or this and that and then make money. In few cases you can make money, but in that case you need to work here in out of 24 hours you need to work 18 hours a day, 7 days in a week, maybe 30 days in a month. Every day you need to work, then you can make maybe 14,000. So what is the maximum amount you can make here in Australia? The maximum amount of in Australia by working odd jobs on 20-hour limitation, you can make only $5,000 to $10,000. So still you are out of $4,000. So imagine if you have a $14,000 semester fees, how you gonna make it? So what people do is the first semester is already paid. The second semester they need to pay. With the second semester, what the people do it, they go to the bank and they get the credit card, which starts from maybe sometimes 6,000, 8,000, 10,000. So they get 6,000 from there and they work hard, keep working and save money, all the money, and then they pay half of the fees by from their credit card, half of the fees by what they have earned. So this is how they make money. And then the first semester is paid already. The second semester you paid by the credit card and you work hard, and then the third semester what they do, the third semester they change their university to a lower level of institute or colleges, okay, and then the fees reduce from 14,000 to 8,000, okay. And then the second thing what they do, once they change it to lower level universities and college, and then they defer their semester. So after studying 2 semester or even 1 semester, they change the university, come into the lower level universities, colleges, they start studying over there, and then they defer the semester. Once they defer the semester, it means you have 4 months time, in which if you have a deferred semester, you can work full time. That's how they make money. So people asking me the same question again and again, will you able to pay your fees? Will you able to work out how to pay 14,000? This is the way, guys. Don't ask me again and again same question, how to make money, how to make money. I've told you everything. Come here, first semester fees is paid, second semester you take a loan of credit card and work hard, or half of the money you pay the second semester, change your university, change into lower university, lower institute, which is $8,000 or $10,000, and then that defer the college semester. Once you defer the semester, you got a 4 months time, you work hard in that, because you will allow to have full working rights if you are deferred the semester, if you're not studying with it. So semester break give you a time in which you can work full time. This is the law here, I'm telling you guys. So whoever coming here in Australia, show this video to all other people how much money you can make. Roughly you can make it like by working day and night, $8,000 to $10,000 in four months time, which is for 1 semester. 4 months you can make out of all of your saving, everything you can make easily from $5,000 to $10,000, which is in saving, and the rest of it you need to pay your bills, your credit card, your rent, which is the most expense you're gonna get it here, depending where you're living. So guys, don't lose your hope. You're gonna come here in Australia, but don't expect from me or from others that you're gonna make the whole amount of money. You need to work hard, at the same time you need to work smart. This is how you can make money. So everyone whoever is coming in Australia, I'm telling you the truth, the ground reality. All the consultant gonna tell you, oh, you can make money this and that, this and that, you can do this. All the consultant not on the level on which I came here, okay. Maybe the consultants have been here for 5 or 10 years, they don't know the ground reality, what the students are facing. The student facing too much stress, students are facing too much like hectic schedules. I came here when I was so young, now I'm getting old, just because I've been here for 5 years and I haven't done anything which I was expecting from myself. Keep pushing myself, working as an Uber driver, keep pushing myself working as a taxi driver, working hard, even though I don't make any friends here. And then what I made, I made money and I pay all of my fees. I have never asked to my family to pay my bills, to pay my university fees, even though whenever I get chance, I send some of the money to make them feel happy. Okay, all right, that I'm studying here and I'm working hard here as well. So guys, if you have dreams and goals in your life in which you want to achieve, you want to be a happier life, you need to work smart, you need to work hard, and then you need to get out from the box. People coming from Pakistan, India, Nepal, China, Japan, or everyone, those people who are coming, especially Thailand and Vietnam as well, these people are working so hard here. Most of the people are well educated from their countries, but they are coming here in this country to work hard. And what we are working here? We are working here as a taxi driver, we are working as a cafes, restaurants, we are working as a cleaner to do the mop, cleaning, cafe, restaurant. On everything we are working here, normally Australian people are not flexible to work as a taxi driver for 12 hours or for cleaning the toilets and everything. I love Australia, I love Australian people, I have a lot of Australian friends as well, but what I'm telling you guys, that whatever we are working here to pay our fees is not a piece of cake. Because if you, once you be Australian, you're gonna get the government support. The government support you that you study now, they pay all the fees for you, and once you start getting money and you start getting good job, then you can pay back to the government, which was the easiest way. If you won't be able to get enough money, you keep waiting until you hit the bar and then you start paying. So all the people who ask me about the scholarship, guys who are coming on student visa, you're not gonna get scholarship. Scholarship is the people who are just like studying on a very high grade, or which they get like very extremely high grades, then they get a scholarship from their own countries, not coming here and then asking the if I come here and a scholarship and how much money I can make or how much money I can save. Guys, most of the people are average students, and the study level here is the most easiest as compared to countries from my country, from Pakistan, from India as well, and from China or maybe from Japan as well. Because coming here, the study level, I don't know, maybe I'm from fortunate family that I have studied in a good university, but the standard of study is similar or little bit up and down. So you can study here easily. So the making of video is this one. Yes, you can earn money, but don't expect yourself that you're gonna come here and then you're gonna make $14,000 for a semester. It's not possible. So you need to work smartly to get a loan a little bit from the bank, and then work hard and make money, half of it, and then half of it from loan, and then the next semester you defer it, reduce them from jump from top university to the lower institute, and then this is how you're gonna run. After 1 year, you're gonna have more opportunities to work, you're gonna know what's Melbourne, what's Sydney, what Australia is all about, then you start working yourself. All right guys, if you like my video, I know I was a bit fast, I know it was a bit more fast video, but I talk a little bit fast. If you like my video, please thumb up, share, and do check out my other videos as well. Most of my videos are in Urdu language, and Urdu or Hindi, which mostly Pakistani and Indian people understand. But yeah, this one is because a lot of people were asking me to make a video in English. So Chinese, Japanese, or everyone, people from Thailand, Vietnam, they might understand. So guys, do subscribe my channel and thumbs up, share, like, and do come in Australia. I love Australia, I love everyone. The best city, Melbourne, is the most multicultural city, the best city in the world for the sixth time. Isn't it beautiful? Please come out from their boxes, start living their life. It's hard, but it's worth it in the end. Take care of guys. I'm your host, Saif Fawad Javed. Bless me, pray for me. Please remember me in your prayers. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Bye.